A joint opposition group in Uganda has called for a peaceful protest today, Thursday, to raise awareness about what they call poor roads in Uganda. This as Uganda hosts the Non-Aligned Movement Summit tomorrow, Friday. The police say the protest is intended to tarnish the country's image and will not allow the demonstration. The Uganda Monitor newspaper quotes police spokesperson Fred Enanga as saying opposition protests have never been peaceful. Opposition leader Robert Chakulai, also known as Bobby Wine, rejects the allegation. He tells me the protesters will also demand the whereabouts of allegedly missing opposition supporters.
The purpose of the protest is to demand for the 18 missing people that were abducted and taken away by security never to be seen again.
These are the supporters of your party?
Yes, please.
The opposition has been protesting or boycotting parliament because of this. Ugandan officials are saying that they don't know whether they are holding any of your supporters because they don't have information on that.
But they were taken in live view of camera. General Museveni, the president, went about them and conceded that he has them. The country came out loudly and confessed that she has them. This was months ago.
So let's talk about the protest. The police are saying they are not going to allow you to protest because your protests have never been peaceful.
But we've never been violent. We've never been violent. Our protests are always peaceful. We have never been violent in our protests, and we intend to be non-violent even this time around. You know, violence only comes when the police cracks down on the people, beats them and arrests them and tortures them, not the people themselves.
As you know, Honorable, the Non-Aligned Summit is taking place on Friday. The government is saying you are protesting or you want to protest to tarnish the image of Uganda.
No, we want to protest the gross human rights situation in Uganda that is happening. What tarnishes the government is what they do, gross human rights violations. What we highlight the situation, we only expose the atrocities. They know that what they're doing is a violation of the norms that established the non-aligned movement, and they're not respecting the principles that bring them together.
Are you saying, therefore, you are going to protest? Do you have permission from the police to do so?
Yes.
Opposition leader Robert Chakulai, also known as Bobby Wine, he was speaking with us from the Ugandan capital, Kampala. The Airlines Information Minister has confirmed that a court has granted permission for former President Ernest Bai Koroma to travel to Nigeria for medical reasons. Koroma is facing charges of treason and other offenses for his role in an alleged coup attempt last November. He has denied the accusations. Information Minister Chun Oba would not say whether the medical trip was requested by the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS. He tells me the decision is consistent with the laws of Sierra Leone.
The former president's lawyers made an application for a modification of his bail terms, and they specifically requested that he be allowed to travel to the Federal Republic of Nigeria so that he can attend to his medical needs. They presented evidence of this in court. There was a debate between his lawyers and the lawyers of the government of Sierra Leone, and the court made a judgment that allowed for the modifications of the bail conditions and for the former president to be allowed to travel to Nigeria.
Is this usual, Minister?
It is definitely consistent with the rule of law that lawyers can apply for a leave to allow their client to travel to attend to desperate medical needs. In this case, the former president lawyers have made a case that convinced the court. It's also important to point out that there are other conditions. So those conditions include that they will be consistently reporting back to the court on his medical situation and that they have a return date. The lower court did adjourn the case when the lawyers of the government of Sierra Leone will be back in court. So whatever happens in between that, you know, this is now part of, you know, as far as we know, the case is still on, and this is consistent with the laws of our country.
I asked the question because I think it was just 2 weeks ago that we talked about the former president going to Nigeria at the request of ECOWAS. Is this the same or this is different?
This is certainly different. As I said, this is a product of the court proceedings in Sierra Leone, debate and application that the court has granted. And again, the application is very clear. They are seeking for their clients to be allowed to seek medical attention in court. I think what we want to make clear, James, is that Sierra Leone is a country of laws. We abide by the rule of law, and that's the position that the government of Sierra Leone has had from the first day of this investigation and the incident of November 26th. And today's ruling is simply consistent with that.
So ECOWAS had nothing to do with this?
Well, again, I will not speculate on what ECOWAS had something to do with or not, but what I can say is that the courts of Sierra Leone, the judiciary of Sierra Leone in front of our Justice Samuel Taylor, did receive an application that was consistent with the rules of our country, that was very clear in terms of the medical condition of the former president, Dr. Ernest Bai Koroma, and that request was granted.
Because this is unusual. So if one of the people charged with treason, if they request to the court, if they put in a request to the court, would the court also grant that?
James, as you know, I cannot speculate on what the court can or cannot do, but what I can tell you is that this is consistent with the rule of law of Sierra Leone.
What was the time spent for the president's trip? What did the court say in terms of how long he should stay?
As I said, that the matter has been adjourned to the first week of March. So we're expecting that the former president's lawyers, at the very least, will be back in court on the date of the case. And whatever happens in between that now is different. But what we know for now, the judgment of the court is that, A, he is granted bail to leave the country, and that the matter is adjourned. So the case is still on.
Joined by Sierra Leone's Information Minister, he was speaking with us from the capital, Freetown. Human rights.
An Ethiopian Airlines flight was Wednesday denied access to Somalia airspace after Mogadishu authorities said it lacked proper permission. The aircraft reported to be carrying a high-level Ethiopian delegation was said to have been heading to Hargeisa, the capital of the breakaway Somaliland. Somalia Civil Aviation said it ordered the return of the Ethiopian flight for lacking necessary clearance to use Somali airspace. Today, the Somalia Civil Aviation Authority took action to turn back an Ethiopian Airlines plane, -8Q400, flight number ET8372, from Somali airspace as it was found to be unauthorized, adhering to international air rules and our rules. Flights must obtain proper permission before entering airspace, said the agency. The development comes amid a diplomatic row between Somalia and Ethiopia after Addis Ababa signed a memorandum of understanding to secure its access to the Red Sea with a separatist Somaliland. Somaliland has claimed autonomy since 1991, but it is not internationally recognized under the memorandum of understanding signed January 1st. Somaliland agreed to lease 20 kilometers of its coast for 50 years to landlocked Ethiopia, which indicated it wants to set up a naval base and a commercial port. The United States, the European Union, the African Union, the Arab League, and China have urged Ethiopia to respect Somalia's territorial integrity.